Well, I guess today's video is going to be on how I deal with crappy weather while living in a van. Hello, friends, family. Total strangers? Let me get the sun. Oh, there we go. The sun is out, so I light my face a little better. So yeah, this video is on how I stay warm in the winter. Today is my first snow day in the van, and hopefully my only snow day in the van. The main way that I stay warm is just by being low elevation in the south. Specifically, Arizona is what I've done this winter, and it's been great. However, I saw this day in the forecast was coming. So I'm camped at about 5,000 feet right now, which has been beautiful. It's been, you know, mid-60s. And after today, it's going to be back in the mid-60s, lows in the high 30s, even up into the 40s starting next week. Even at this elevation at 5,000 feet. So I had the choice of, for one day, do I really want to drive off down into the lowlands to save a few degrees where it's still probably going to be in the 50s, or just tough out one day in the 40s. It's supposed to be 45 today. I didn't know it was going to snow, though. I didn't realize it was going to snow, but whatever. So I have, my main way, other than, you know, heading south, other than trying to stay in warm areas in the winter, I don't have heater in the van. I have a Mr. Buddy, but I never use it. So I pretty much just bundle up for the few times that I'm gonna need it, and I have a 0 degree bag. The Mr. Buddy heater, you know, my van is so small, I might be able to burn it in there safely with, you know, my window cracked and my vent fan on. But all said and done, there's not enough of a need for it. There's really, for me, at least the way it's been this winter, there hasn't really been a need for my Mr. Buddy, so I think I'm going to get rid of it. I've got a 0 degree bag, so no matter how cold it is, I can get in there. One of the big things is just having layers, being able to have a bunch of layers that you can put on to stay warm. My van isn't really set up to live in. So what really stinks for my van is rain, heavy snow, high wind, the things that drive you inside, because it's just not a great inside space. And it wasn't set up to be. I'm set up to live out of my van, not in it. So cooking becomes a challenge inside the van. I can do it. I can use my Road Pro and I can get around it, but I don't have a great counter space to work with. I can make it all work, but it's not set up to live in there. It is set up to live out here and then sleep in there. So I'll probably spend most of the day just editing editing video. I have all my Chiricahua video that I need to edit. Or at least that was the plan. The sun's out now. So if the sun's out and it's 45 degrees, that's definitely more manageable because I don't have to curl up in my sleeping bag in the van away from rain and snow. I can be out here. I can go for a hike is a great way to stay warm. Although I hiked 15 miles yesterday, so that doesn't sound super appealing right now. But yeah, the sun's out, so I might even sit out a chair and drink my coffee. So here's my Mr. Buddy heater. You can use a propane. You can use like a propane tank with it. You have to get a filter, a special filter and a special hose to use it. But otherwise you can just use it with the green bottles. And this is what most van dwellers use. For me, I don't bother with a propane tank for anything because I just don't use that much propane to warrant using up that much space in my tiny van. So these little green bottles work just fine for me. However, yeah, the Mr. Buddy, this is what most people use. It's just, I don't find it necessary. I don't really need it. I'm going to get rid of it. It takes up space in my van that I can find better use for that space than this thing, which all said and done, I might only use a couple of times a year. And I might as well just bundle up through those couple times and save the space, save the gas. So, yeah, they're fine. And if I had a bigger van, it might make sense. A van that I would want to spend time in. But my van is so small, I don't want to spend time in it. So if you don't want to spend time in the van, what's the point of having a heater to heat that space? Yeah, no point to me.
Snow is lame.
So, yeah, it's supposed to be cold tonight, really cold, which is no big deal in the sleeping bag. The terrible thing is when you have to get out of the sleeping bag in the morning. Not super awesome. Like, it's hard to, when it's, you know, 25 degrees outside of your sleeping bag and you're all warm and toasty in there, it's pretty hard to motivate out of it. So, but yeah, I think what I'll do in the morning, so a lot of people might, you know, think that I can just get in my car and start it up and warm up my van that way. I could. It's going to take a while, especially because of the, I've only got heat in the front. So to get it into the back, I have to open up the curtains, and it's just going to take a while for that heat to get back there and really warm up the van. So it's not super practical unless I'm going to drive somewhere, which is another thing I can do when it's cold, is I can just go to inside spaces. So, for example, there's a library, a public library, about, it's actually really close. It's only about a 10-minute drive from here, down in the town of, I don't know. But I looked it up. There's a library about 10 minutes away. And so tomorrow morning when I wake up, I'll probably wake up, make my coffee, and then just drive down to the library and spend the morning in the library until it warms up. And then by that time, it's supposed to get back up into the 60s tomorrow. And yeah, it'll be fine. So that's how I deal with that. So yeah, the last thing I'll talk about is just the different places you can winter. There's four main states that people winter in, being California, Florida, Texas, and Arizona. So Arizona has a ton of public land, like lots of BLM land, like so much BLM land, lots of national forest land. So lots of different options, just so many different options. Diverse scenery, diverse wildlife, lots of national parks, lots of national monuments, lots of cliff dwellings, and just interesting things to see. This is a great place to spend a winter. So I might do future winters. I might travel a little more and just get down to Texas and maybe even down to Florida and explore around down there and just get a little variety. And probably California. I'll probably spend some time in a winter in California in the future. But this winter in Arizona has been awesome. So I've really enjoyed it. But yeah, you don't necessarily have to stay to those four states either. You can travel around and just watch the weather. And I think that's where I feel most van dwellers go wrong, is they just stay in the ugly brown desert of Quartzsite and that area and over in California, that ugly brown desert, when all you have to do is watch the weather and you can go to beautiful places with trees. And, you know, maybe this isn't the best day to do that since it snowed on me. To do this video where I'm telling you you can go all these places, but it's going to be back up in the 60s tomorrow and then in the 40s overnight. So yeah, you don't have to stick to that brown ugly desert in the winter time. You know, there's lots of beautiful places you can go and lots of diverse scenery you can get to just by watching the weather and paying attention and yeah, be flexible. Be flexible and ready to go, you know, ready to go places. So I'm staying in the dispersed camping area, and yesterday I set out to just see how far of a walk it was to the bathroom with my coffee in hand. It turned out there is a campground that has a bathroom. It's about a 40-minute walk away, about 2 miles. And, yeah, it turned into a 15-mile hike. I hadn't planned on hiking. I was just going to the bathroom and I was going to do the hike today. But, coffee in hand, I just thought it'd be fun to do it. So 15 miles, it was a blast. So I might have gone a little overboard with my bacon pesto half-pound burger with avocado and fried egg. I just hiked 15 miles and I'm really hungry, but I don't know how I'm going to fit that in my face. So this is the east side of the Dragoon Mountains, and yesterday I did hike over to the west side and back. pretty big hike. But yeah, that's my video. Please like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. Thanks a bunch. Thank you.